Hello friends, welcome to Learn Positive with Pradeep Kumar. If you are seeing my channel, like, share, comment, subscribe, click the bell icon. Manufacturing process, unit 1, foundry technology, part 8. If you want to see my previous videos, click the I button on the top of the video. You will see all the playlist in my channel and subscribe to my channel. Types of molding, green sand molding, dry sand molding and loam sand molding. These three types of molding is there. We will see one by one briefly. First one is green sand molding. The process of making mold by using green sand is called green sand molding. After the mold is prepared, the molten metal is poured into the mold to produce casting. Now we are going to see the following step by step procedure of making green sand using split pattern. It will show in the diagram one by one in the right hand side. Now place one half of the pattern on the molding board. The bottom one is called molding board and the pattern is in the green color. The molding sands are in yellow color. There was a strike of bar at the top of the drawing. It was in the operation. So we will see in the procedure. Place the drag box upside down on the molding board and parting sand is sprinkled over the pattern. The parting sand was using because to separate the pattern from the mold after removing. It will not stick into the mold. Then 20 mm layer of facing sand is filled around the pattern. Then the green sand is filled in the box. Ramming is done uniformly by using rammer. The excess sand is removed and leveled by the strike of bar. The operation done by the strike of bar at the top of the drawing is there. And vent holes are made, the box is tilted upside down. The coke box and another half of the pattern are placed correctly by use of dowel pins. Potting sand is sprayed over the pattern. The runner pin and riser pin are placed in the coke box at correct position. Then facing sand and molding sand are filled. Ramming is done uniformly. Vent holes are made. Runner pin and riser pin are removed and pouring cup is made. Coke and drag boxes are separated so as to remove the pattern. Draw spike is driven into the pattern pieces and shaken lightly in all directions, then remove the piece or withdraw it slowly. Runner and gate are cut in drag portions. Core is placed in the mold if necessary. If there is no holes in the pattern, we don't need to use the core in the pattern. And then the cope and drag box are assembled in correct position and weight is placed over the cope due to the pressure of molten metal. It will remove, so we will place a weight over the cope box. Finally, molten metal can be poured into the mold for producing casting. The molten metal is poured through the runner and it will passing through the gate to the mold. It will fill the mold and then it will shown up on the riser. When the molten metal is shown on the riser, the mold is fully filled with the molten metal. And the next topic is dry sand molding. Dry sand mold is obtained after heating the green sand mold. The procedure for making dry sand mold is same as that of green sand mold. The large molds are heated by oxyacetylene flames and small molds are heated in ovens. Application of dry sand molding. It is used for producing engine cylinders, engine blocks and mill rolls. Advantages. It is stronger than green sand mold. It is not damaged while handling. More dimensional accuracy. Smooth surface finish can be obtained. Casting defects like blowholes will not occur due to there is no moisture in the dry sand. Disadvantages. It requires heating, more time is needed and cost is more. The next one is loam sand molding. Since loam sand is used for this molding, so it is called as loam sand molding. It does not require solid pattern and molding box. Loam sand consists of silica, clay and fire clay. The clay is 50%. The fire clay is made from the clay. It was fire. The clay was fired and then it was make it as a powder and mixed with water means we get the fire clay. First, a rough framework is made by using fire bricks and iron pieces. Then the loam sand is applied over the framework. It was shown in the right hand side diagram. Then the required mold is prepared by using suitable swipe pattern or skeleton pattern. This loam made can be used after graying application. It is used for producing large castings like cylinders, bells, gears and machine parts. The advantages of loam sand molding is good surface finish can be obtained. It does not require molding box. Accurate casting can be produced. Disadvantages: it requires more time. It is not suitable for small casting. Friends, if you like the channel, please give a thumbs up, share with your friends, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.